Trevor Hoffman could have inspired the saying, never let them see you sweat. With the game on the line, his game face is on. Sober, stoic, even as his adrenaline is pumping.
So high. I mean, your heart's pumping and you're tight, you're trying to calm down, and you know the lineup, you know the three guys you're gonna face when you go in there. But once I get out to the main mound out there, it's like, it's calm. You know, this is where I wanted to be for the last 3 hours.
This is where he's wanted to be his whole life. Trevor William Hoffman was born October 13th, 1967, raised in Anaheim, California.
I think I was a pretty happy kid, to be honest with you. Two loving parents that allowed me to just be myself and not have a lot of pressures on me.
And two older brothers he craved to be with, wanted to be like.
To one day beat them at something. And you know, I'm doing this at 5 years old, 6 years old, and all they're worried about was eliminating me from their ping pong game or the wiffle ball game.
He wouldn't go off and play with his buddies. He wanted to stick around. So we'd have all these type of, you know, rules to get rid of him. Baseball, okay, you can hit until you strike out. 1, 2, 3, gone. Okay, next guy. You know, stuff like that.
The competitive nature, I think, comes just from being three boys and growing up together and fighting over what's on the table to eat or what card game we're going to play.
At just 6 weeks old, Trevor had a defective kidney removed, restricting him from contact sports, but not much else. His brother Greg, 13 years older, pursued high school basketball coaching and teaching special education. Glenn, 10 years older than Trevor, became a Major League Baseball player. While sports dominated their household, his parents' story inspired his appreciation for the arts. In 1950, Trevor's mother, Mickey, was a blossoming British ballerina. His father, Ed, an American and war veteran, was the tenor in the traveling quartet, the Royal Guards.
He had a fabulous voice.
They met in England, shared a stage for a command performance for the King and Queen. Romance bridged a 20-year age difference. They were married 43 years before Ed Hoffman died of cancer in 1995.
I think of him every day, and it's been extremely tough having gone through some of these things that I know he would have loved and would love to experience.
I don't think I ever heard him have a crossword with his boys. I took on the tough role, and their dad was always the soft spot.